Is it worth staying in Orisson? Just 8 kilometres from Saint-Jean. What services are there? What's really up with those shower tokens? Is it going to be the hardest day of your Camino? Is it easier to go via Valcarlos? And how we nearly died by listening to locals. I'm Mike, and I make helper videos on the Camino. To Orisson or not to Orisson? That is the question. Bad Hamlet aside, this is really a question for day one if you're doing the Camino Francés starting in Saint-Jean-Pied-de-Port. You have two paths to choose from, the Valcarlos route, which is shorter, less steep, does not have so much elevation gain, but it's often walking by a road at times and it has far less pretty views. Or the Route de Napoleon, or the Napoleon route, which is steeper, climbs higher, but it's very pretty, unless you're like me and had thick clouds, sideways rain and snowfalls, making it pretty much miserable. Which is why they close it during the winter months. On the Napoleon route is the bar and accommodation known as Orisson. The bar is on the uphill side, and in the foreground you have the accommodation. This footage is from the homepage of their website, and I think they've done a wonderful job. When it comes to deciding to stay at Orisson or push through, there are a few things to know. Saint-Jean is about 160 metres above sea level, while Orisson is 900 metres. It's not that much by Camino standards, but, and it's a big but. No, not big buck, big but. Well, that's a but, but look, anyway. The issue with Saint-Jean to Orisson is that if you don't stop and keep going, the next stop is in Spain at Roncesvalles. This means that rather than just 8 kilometres with 740 metres gain, you do 25.1 kilometres in a day with a peak of 1,450 metres. At that height, it's going to be much colder and the air is thinner. If you're not used to hiking at elevation, you'll notice your energy drop. When we went over the top in June, which is fully into summer, it snowed on us. They say the day you're most likely to be injured or give up is day one, Saint-Jean-Pied-de-Port to Roncesvalles. If your fitness is not fully up to speed, you have a physical limitation, the weather is bad, or in my case, all three, I suggest you make day one an easy day and stop at Orisson. If your nickname is Rambo and your favourite phrase is
Yippee-ki-yay, mother,
then I think pushing through in one day is the way to prove to yourself Despite the best of plans, on your first day your pack will most likely be the heaviest for all of Camino. Not only are you carrying all the consumables that will be used along the way, your pack is also full of all the junk that you really don't need and will probably give away, dump, or post home before Santiago. So on day one, you'll be the least fit, have the heaviest pack, and one of, if not the hardest days, of your Camino if you decide to push through. Orisson has nice beds. My room had 4 bunks, 8 people, and it was quite good in that regard. They also have nice little lock boxes with USB chargers built into them, which was uncommon for the Camino. They do use token-operated shower timers. These little suckers go on from the moment the token is dropped, regardless if the water is on or not. So get yourself naked, get ready to get wet, and at that moment you drop the token in, start showering. Do not stop the water partway through, thinking the timer will pause. In the bar is a great place to eat, drink, and be merry. Even if you're not staying, it's a great place to stop for an eat on the way over the top. There was no Wi-Fi in 2019, and I don't think they've added it since. There are not any other shops or facilities there, just the bar and accommodation. As Orisson will be night one for most of the peregrinos or pilgrims, you'll also get to stand up and say why you're on the Camino. It's nice to see why others are doing it, and it forces you to think, why the hell are you doing this? The accommodation cost is expensive, however, dinner and breakfast is included in the price, which makes it much more reasonable. The meals are nice, and there are vegetarian options, but not vegan options. There are no other choices for food other than the bar. Breakfast is simple and quick, but you want to eat as much as you can, as the only other food for the day is the caravan near the top by the border. Aside from that, no services to Roncesvalles. A word of warning. In the movie The Way, the policeman talks to Martin Sheen's character about how his son went ill-prepared over the Pyrenees and died, saying,
"The weather in the Pyrenees is famous for being unpredictable, and I'm sure Daniel would have been warned by the locals."
Well, the operator at Orisson told us it looked like a beautiful day. The clouds are above the mountains. It should be a lovely day. So we shipped most of our cold weather gear forward on his weather prediction. And it snowed. And we nearly reenacted the sun dying in the movie. Literally. Although we had a basic poncho, waterproof pants and jackets, we sweated up so badly our wet clothes under the waterproof sapped the heat from our bodies. We had to hike non-stop, as we knew being wet, if we stopped the exertion of walking, we would freeze up and die. We hiked over the top for hours with freezing hands burning from the cold, and I had to walk with them in my armpits. I could not even use my phone or camera, as every time I got my hands out, it would freeze them even more. Miserable. The locals would have warmed him. No, they bloody might have said the opposite. Orisson has very limited beds. Regardless of the season, bookings are essential. I have the details in the description below. Don't forget to comment, like, and subscribe, please. No, really, it's important. I've got a mountain of content I want to share, and subscribers helps me share the Camino love. If you want to know about pilgrims' passports and sell us, click on that episode. What is this Camino thing anyway? Click on that one.